I'm going to go to the hospital. We are very happy and delighted to have in our midst today the chief of the Nawa Southern Crossing. Yes. Sir, I must say we are highly honored. Sir, not to take much of your time, we have here some sector commanders and very senior that may want to interact with you. So I think it's better I give the floor open in case there's one or two things that maybe they will have an opportunity to hear instead of an office. You're welcome once again, sir. Thank you.
Something that gladdens our hearts, sir. It has raised the morale of the troops, it has raised the morale of the commanders. And,
good synergy between the troops has been most wonderful, but I think I want to appreciate you, sir, for making that very possible. And we assure you on our part, we continue to do the best we can to ensure that there's future peace in the office.
The Commander Joint Air Force, the current Major General, Mr. C.G. Musa, our host Commander 19 Battalion, Brigadier General A. Haruna, my senior alpha meter, the Commander Naval Base in Charge, Commodore Alex Ingel, Principal Staff Officers from the Naval Headquarters Surgery, very senior officers, and the Commander, Maritime Component Commander, Commodore Arun Sharma. Our guest journalist, the new veteran, is also in the military family, Mr. Andachi of Blueprint. Our colleagues from the Nigerian Police Force, the Civil Defense, and of course, mon ami, they refuse to put you on the processor. Good afternoon. Well, I thought I was going to address majorly, other than the commanders, the personnel of the naval component of this operation. That is the personnel of the naval base in Pakistan. However, I will be a bit selfish while I give the general comments to the effect the synergy among the armed forces of Nigeria and also members of the multinational joint task force here. I will first of all want to congratulate the commander, Naval Base Abaga, for returning successfully to Abaga. Your professional conduct, you and your staff, and you should know that it's very necessary for the sustenance, you know, of this operation. I urge you to maintain the momentum in collaboration with other sister services, so that eventually we will achieve the strategic end state. This is a pleasure. Of course, in line with my vision and mission for the Nigerian Navy. You also need to realize that the President has given us the mandate to, within the shortest possible time, end this insurgency for economic activity to drive. To thrive in our company. So always put that in focus. And it is our hope the service change that come December. We hope that by the time that we make sure that Nigeria and our neighbors in this environment usher in the new year with a high degree of disseminated insurgency around the region. So I felt I should emphasize on that. And then of course, I want to assure you that we at the Naval headquarters are not going to leave any stone unturned to make sure that they are equipped, both in terms of logistics and vehicular and goods requirements for you to be able to work alongside our sister services and other sculpture agencies to bring a lasting peace to Baga first and to the region in general so that life can return to normal. I am aware that Baga is one of the richest local governments in the state that even generates a good amount of promotion. So therefore, achievement of the objective of getting a lasting peace here will not be able to overemphasize. So please synergize to make sure that you will succeed in your mandate. At the same time, the conduct of your personnel, everybody will be extra alert. You will be extra vigilant so that what happened when all of you left Baga should not reoccur again. And of course, that goes to the land component, especially. You know, you need to be alive first and safe to be able to hold the ground. So if you are caught napping, you will run and they will shoot you from the back and you are gone forever. Remember, we all have own families and you have extended families. The way we are so caught. So very important that you must be vigilant at all times. You know, so that you can be able to operate in this theater. And like I said earlier, we are going to make sure that we provision all your operational assets and logistics and requirements. That's why I'm here with the Chief of Training and Operations and the Chief of Logistics. The Provost Marshal is here, administration of course. The DNA is here to also hear what intelligence requirements you need. Thank God your communication and equipment that you need, we are fulfilling most of it. Any other immediate requirement that you can grab, you go back, you quickly get if you don't have people to facilitate to bring diagnostics, we will get the right contractors or consultants to come and help you. I want to also emphasize the issue of your corporate social responsibility, which is the provision of water. Get that done so that you give more water to the people. They say he who brings water brings life. And then again, we look at the issue of small football teams. That also goes to the land component commanders, the police, the civil defense. I'd like you guys to look at that that area so that you can have the youths. Even if they don't go to school through the week, because you told me, you teach some lessons, education personnel, of course the services used to teach English and mathematics and all that. But again, let them be actively engaged in sports so that they will not be contributed by this by the insurgents. I should talk about that. Then of course, the issue of synergy of efforts and cooperation, that too cannot be overemphasized. You can see Monami here, our brother from the multinational joint task force. Our common heritage in this region is affected by the issue of insurgency, and so therefore the more we cooperate, the more this environment will be secure for economic activity, the well-being of the people. And of course, I want you to know that is very dear to the government at the grand strategic level coming down. So we must cooperate with our borders, from the region, notably the Cameroons, the Chadians, the Nigerians. We must cooperate with them so that in quick time we secure this environment through the effort of the contingencies for an enduring security in the region. And again, the issue of substance and drug abuse, that too you have to look into. We talk to the soldiers, the sailors, the airmen. So, this is from drug abuse. Well, for those of you in the Navy, anybody that is caught, abusing drugs, will not hesitate to hand the person over to the appropriate law enforcement agency. I felt I should let you know that too. And then the issue of welfare concerns. This goes to you now, Commander Pinker, and of course, Sharma. Anything that concerns welfare of your personnel, you know, I personally don't joke with the welfare of officers and men, because the man remains the most important factor in any operation. So therefore, you should make sure that you actively engage the naval headquarters, establishments and units of the Nigerian Navy at ensuring that all the logistics requirements in the department are provisioned for you so that you take care of your troops. Notably, the issue of uniforms, I've directed the Chief of Logistics to look at it so that at least each personnel in theater will have 2 pairs of the desert camo and other accessories, as the case may be. So please take note of that. I think at this juncture, I would like to thank the theater commander, the commander multinational joint task force, and all other commanders for making this visit a success. And I assure you that since I've come here on ground, I will relate that to my colleagues when I get back to Abuja on issues of operations and welfare as well. And with rapidity, we are going to make sure that you are as comfortable as possible in Baga. Behold, I think I'm happy to be here, and also members of my team. I will say happy Eid al-Mawlud for the Muslims of us.
Thank the CNS for finding time despite its tight schedule, especially on a day like this that's supposed to be a public holiday, to come and visit us here in Baga. Sir, I can assure you that your visit will remain in our hearts for a very long time to come, and it will indeed push us to want to do more, because we have seen care, we have seen love from our chief. So, sir, on behalf of the whole theater, I wish to thank you for coming, and it's a fervent prayer that as you go back, God will give you
more rock!
Hey!
More rock!
Hey!
More rock!
Hey!
Give me the
Sorry, this is the only good opportunity for me to come around here. I'm sure you understood that 2 days ago we were supposed to be here. But we couldn't get the flight, and I think this is God's own time. But alhamdulillah, we are here today. And I want to congratulate you for coming back to Baga.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, you are 6 weeks old already here in town. And the community is very happy to have you back. Your colleagues in the army and other security agencies are also happy to have you back. So you can see the expectation is very high from you. Is that also?
Yes, sir.
So gentlemen, your conduct must continue to be professional and top-notch. I want to appreciate your conduct too. We are going to look at the issue of your uniform and perhaps some accessories. And we hope to make 2 pairs each for you. Is that clear?
Clear, sir!
Yes, sir.
So I'm here again. Gentlemen, we greatly appreciate you all. That is why I came here personally, to show you our commitment. The federal government looks up to all of you, the armed forces of Nigeria, as well as our friends in the multinational joint task force to bring lasting peace to this environment, the Northeast in general. Okay? So we will do all things possible. We have heard from the commander already. For Navy, I know what I'm expected to do. I will support you guys as well as our friends in the other services and other security agencies. So I give you my word, what I've said, you will see the Naval Headquarters will match word for action. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So God bless you all, and I wish you safe keep while you are in these operations. God bless you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. So we have to go back to my duty and Abuja today.
Captain!
End of address. Request permission. Direct standard machine.
Sir! Thank you.
I am
yes, for breaking the court.
Okay.
People have been expecting service chiefs in this line. The villagers, whenever we are entering that gate, we are going to meet you. The club is here. We are very much happy. And we have been promising that our father is coming. We are very over happy to see you.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
I'm here.
Thank you very much. We are very much
happy. We stopped and greeted them at the market too.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'm asking people, I'm asking people.